What's up, guys? Max here, and just back from Evo not too long ago, and finally have had the opportunity to break down and look at some of all these freaking Killer Instinct videos I have. Now, the footage you're watching in the background is actually me initially learning how to play Glacius when he was first available publicly on the floor of Evo 2013. And this is my first chance using him, so it's a little learning the ropes and stuff like that, because he's definitely an odd character. What I will say is that stay tuned, because I do have some direct capture stuff of Glacius and of learning the game. However, I am waiting for some approval from Microsoft and the Double Helix guys if it's okay to use this footage, because it's directly captured, but trust me, it's freaking worth it. Stay around, I've got some amazing stuff to show off, and showing off things that nobody has really seen before, watching or playing the game on the floors of like Evo or E3 or anything like that. Just stay tuned for that. As soon as it gets approved, I'll let you guys know. But let's talk about Glacius, and let's talk about a little bit of my first impressions of him and what you can expect from this character. So as you can probably see from the footage running in the background, Glacius is definitely the more unique fighter in the game of three characters so far, than the other two being Jago or Saberwolf. Saberwolf's got some unique things with like running, and Jago is pretty much essentially like the Shoto balance character in the entire game. But Glacius definitely is leaning towards a much different side, and that side is more of a spacing and not as much keep away game, but more of like a zoning character. Which is really weird, because for you guys that have played previous Killer Instincts, that has never existed. A lot of the time in the previous games, and one of the greatest flaws of the original Killer Instincts combat and overall design, is that once you kind of learned one character, or learned one charge character, or one normal move character, you kind of learned them all at that point, and everyone played extremely similar, and extremely similar to each other archetype throughout the game, because everyone was pretty much rushed down. Now, Jago is kind of like, you know, the balance character. He's like sort of in the middle. Saberwolf's an obvious rushdown character, so that's why he feels really similar to old KI. And Glacius now taking this weird archetype of like a zoning character feels totally different. Like this character, and I use this term not loosely, he feels really alien, and that's exactly what he is. A lot of his moves feel really awkward in comparison to the other cast, and not awkward in a bad way, just something that I'm not used to in a Killer Instinct game. Things like he has his puddle punch back, he has his cold shoulder back, things that are like, you know, iconic staple moves of the character. But now he doesn't have his fireball, he has these hail things that come from the sky. He has like a huge variety of new moves, which include unblockables. That's right, he actually has a normal unblockable attack that tracks on the ground and is actually easily avoidable, but is really good for setups and things like that. And that's the one thing that makes Glacius really interesting, and I almost use Glacius exclusively. I'd say throughout like maybe the 100 matches I had, 90 of them were me using Glacius, and I was having a lot of fun learning things. Especially, you guys might have noticed at the stage performance at the end of the day, one of the things that Glacius has is these like crazy full range like auto doubles. Literally, the dude can do auto doubles from max distance across the entire screen, and that is his unique like combo trait. How Jago had his around the world thing, and then Saberwolf had like rapid doubles where you press the same button over and over again. This alien dude can literally combo you from full freaking screen, albeit the sacrifice of that ability is the fact that he just does less damage than Saberwolf and Jago. In my overall impression, my big thing in the new KI is that I try to go for the max damage all the time, and I get really greedy. And I even more understood at Evo the huge cost of sacrificing or risking damage, because the longer your combo goes, the more of a chance you give your opponent to do something like a combo breaker. So a lot of the guys that were really good with Glacius, or the dudes that were on the developer team that were really good with Glacius, like Filthy Rich and like John Batista, who I talked to a lot, these guys were actually getting as much damage as they possibly could very fast. And that's where he seems to be really powerful, is that he gets like 10% here, 15% here from like full distance. He gets like a quick 25% and things like that. I was able to get up to like, you know, 40 to 50% damage with Glacius, but it's actually really hard because a lot of his auto doubles are very easy to scout. You can actually see them and combo break them pretty fast. Now, I don't even want to talk about the new combo breaker system, because I want to make an entire video dedicated to how crazy this is and why there were so many freaking combo breakers on the last day of me playing Glacius on stream at Evo. And a big reason is that, dude, scouting Glacius' moves is pretty freaking easy. It can be really easy, but there is ways around this, and there is, like, manuals and ending your combos earlier and all this type of stuff, but, as far as getting back to Glacius, I'll definitely tell you that you guys that are familiar with characters from other fighting games, like especially Capcom games, Glacius takes some resemblances to a lot of them. Like, I got a huge vibe of Dalsim. He has like a yoga sniper type of move. He has very stretchy limbs that go across the entire screen. He's also very similar to Blackheart from Marvel vs. Capcom 2 as far as his screen presence and some moves as far as like meteors coming from the sky, as well as Dormammu as well, who is already very similar to Blackheart. And he's got a little bit of like Urien in him with like these unblockable setups as far as using special move unblockables and things like that. And as far as just setting up your opponent, that's the thing, is that when you go up against a Glacius that's really freaking good, especially at Evo, he makes you just feel like, oh my god, I'm just getting worked so freaking hard, this guy's insane. But when I use him, like, it's crazy how, like, I see the disadvantages I have using the character the most, because I'm just not as good with him yet. Dude, it's nuts. Like, the character is actually more advanced than the two others that are in the game right now, which is Jago and Saberwolf, which I like. I like that they're going for advanced character archetypes. He's not difficult to use, but he definitely is harder to use than the others right now, if that makes any sense. So I like his appearance a lot. Like, I was talking with the developers a lot about what the hell he looks like, because he's kind of got this, like, watery look around him, and then he controls ice. And what they literally told me is that Glacius is no longer just a T-1000 copy Iceman, which is what I would usually call him. He now is literally an alien exoskeleton that has a suit, that has a mechanical suit that is over his body, which makes sense with all, like, the weird typography and things like that that's all over his body that lights up. It's literally like a robotic suit that lets him control ice and elements and things like that. So it makes a lot more sense when you actually see the character and you understand, like, where his actual story is, because, oh, he actually looks like an alien now. And albeit there's a couple of things in his face I didn't like as much, but when you actually see him in motion and doing things, and like the ice particles are like falling off of each one of his ice attacks, it looks really freaking cool. You're not going to see as much of that really pretty looking stuff in these videos because they're off-screen footage, but stay tuned because I'll have a bunch of stuff. I'll have a full Glacius breakdown where I actually talk to the developers on screen, talking about Glacius, going over all the freaking crazy things he has to give you guys kind of a basic understanding of how I would approach a fighting game character, and that's how I went about this interview with the devs, like learning Glacius and having everybody understand what he's all about. So that's going to be pretty good. Stay tuned, guys, because there'll be plenty more Killer Instinct breakdowns. I'm going to let this one roll a little bit longer with more footage of me using Glacius at the show. And like I said, man, stay tuned for that direct capture footage, because there is some amazing stuff with the music I really need to show you guys. Amazing stuff with the character effects and the backgrounds that I don't think has really been highlighted yet. So thank you all very much for watching. Consider subscribing if you haven't yet, as I'm going deep in on Killer Instinct, man. Like, this game has piqued my interest, especially after Evo now, with all the new mechanics and changes that they're talking about. And oh my god, dem counter breakers. I'll be back very soon, guys. My name is Max, and I'll see you next time. Yeah.